So in this video, we're going to see how we can able to debug our flow as another user. So this is particularly helpful as a flow developer. When you create a flow, before you activate it, you wanted to run multiple test cases or multiple checks, right? How does it work for a manager profile? How does it work for a sales operations profile? How does it work for a marketing operations profile? So you have list of users, right? Configured with a right profile setup, but how do I use the flow screen, the flow canvas, and then debug as different users so that I can ensure as a flow developer that things are working just fine for different profiles, and it is time to activate and then push the flow to the production. So we need to do everything when the flow is being set up, right? So for that reason, okay, Salesforce has given us an option to run a flow as another user, but that option is always disabled. So this is the use case in front of us. Yeah, so you can just see this. there are the use cases. There is a two set of users, sales manager and sales operations team, and we are going to create a new screen flow for them so that they can quickly create prospect partners. So I have sales manager. And sales manager should be able to configure onboarding check and contract status, whereas the sales operation team should not be able to see the onboarding check and contract status. So this configuration, right, is already handled in the system using FLS, because it is very clear that sales operation team should not be given access to see the two fields, right? So if I go to my org, I'm in the account object. Yeah, so this is the partner contract status custom field. You can just see this in the FLS. It is configured as the sales operation team does not have the view access, correct? And same thing, onboarding check needed, again a check custom checkbox field. So for the sales operation team, this is marked as not visible, correct? So now this is handled in the FLS setting, right? So now when I build the flow, okay, so what I should do is I have two users. I have Amy Jackson having sales manager profile. I have John Doe, having sales operations team profile. So I need, as a flow developer, to validate whether the flow, the screen component being built, right, shows the fields, onboarding check needed and partner contract status for Amy. Whereas when John Doe, logs in, it should not show the fields, correct? How do I check that very quickly while the flow is being developed? Very simple. I'll go right here. So this is the flow that was built. Very simple flow. Yeah, so you have this start button, and in this one, right, so you can just see this. There is an account name. Yeah, that is this onboarding state, onboarding check needed checkbox, and that is this one, right? So all the three fields were added through this record variable. Yeah, so that is a record variable that I created. Okay, I can just show you very quickly. So if I go to this toolbox, new resource, right, I can just choose a variable. I can give a variable name. Yeah, variable name, and then I can just choose a data type as record. Then I'll just say refer this account. That's it. Yeah, so once I do that, you can just say this, a new record variable gets created. I can use the record variable, and when the screen component is built, right, I can go to fields, choose the record variable, then just drag and then drop all the fields. So I can just do that. So drag and then drop right here. Yeah, I can do that. Very simple, right? So let's click on done. So now I want to test this across different users, right? Let me save this first as a new version. So I'm going to click on debug. Yeah, I've not activated the flow yet. Yeah, so there is an option called run flow as another user, but this is disabled, right? Of course, this is disabled by default. So what we need to do is, let's close this one. Let's quickly go to our settings. Yeah, the setup, and go to the process settings, process automation settings. So right here, you can find few configurations that are related to the process automation features, like workflow, process builder, and flow. Yeah, so one of the options that we need to enable is this. So let admins debug flow for other users. Yeah, so you need to have, or anybody is having view all permission or manage flow permission, can able to debug as other users. Okay, so when you enable this, then let's see what happens. So let's click on save. Now I'll go back to my flow. I'm going to click on debug. So now you can just see this option is enabled, right? So once you have this option, you will see the drop down, you know, the lookup to choose the users. I'll go with Amy Jackson. Click on run. Okay, I'm seeing account name, account number, onboarding check, and partner status with all the fields, right? Perfect. Yeah. So let me run this again. Let me just close this and then try different inputs. Yeah. So again, I'm going to click on run flow as another user. And then I'm going to click on John Doe. So this time, let's see what happens. You can just see this, right? The other two, you know, fields, right? Onboarding check needed and contract status. Both are, you know, not visible on the screen. This is what is expected, correct? Number one. Number two, you know, before this particular flow is activated, right? Now, as a flow developer or a creator of the flow, I can able to see how this flow works, you know, for various set of users. In that way, as a flow developer, I am confident that this flow will certainly work. Now I can go ahead and then activate this flow. So that's the power of you know, having this, enabling this particular option that helps you to run or debug flow as another user. I hope this was helpful. Thank you.